it's no surprise that the first family needs to follow a certain code of conduct while living in the White House. They can pick their own bedding and repaint certain rooms when they move in, for example, but they cannot touch the historic Lincoln Room or the Yellow Oval Room. They also have to pay for every meal they eat in the White House or Camp David, as noted in former First Lady Laura Bush's post-White House memoir. Former First Lady Michelle Obama has also been open about the rules she and her family had to follow when they moved into the White House back in 2008. While chatting with Oprah Winfrey at the United States of Women Summit in 2016, she recalled when she and her youngest daughter Sasha learned the hard way about the closed window policy.
Sasha opened her window once. There were calls. Shut the window! It never opened again.
Likewise, when a president leaves office, they are also bound by a set of rules, mainly for security reasons. However, the rules don't only apply to a former president, but a former first lady as well. Over the years, former first ladies have shared some insight into what it's like living as the president's wife, but what happens to them after? At this point, Melania Trump is probably accustomed to getting driven and flown privately to various destinations. Luckily for her, she won't need to give that deal up after Donald Trump's presidency ends. According to former first ladies, their days of driving are long over, as long as they maintain Secret Service protection, which is for a lifetime if they so choose. Michelle Obama told Stephen Colbert in a 2015 interview that driving was on her list of things she'd like to do after leaving the White House. But unfortunately, the family's Secret Service agents won't allow it. She told People magazine in 2018, "No driving for me. We still live in a bubble. If we had a farm somewhere, maybe I could drive around it." Former First Lady Hillary Clinton seemingly shares Michelle's frustration, telling the National Automobile Dealers Association in 2014 that she had not been behind the wheel since 1996. Clinton said, "I've always enjoyed stories about cars and adventures, and I have to confess that one of the regrets I have about my public life is that I can't drive anymore." Beyond not driving, what other rules will Melania have to follow? Well, before one first family leaves the White House and a new family enters, the wives from both sides get together, according to Kate Anderson Brower, author of First Women: The Grace and Power of America's Modern First Ladies. Traditionally, the outgoing and incoming first ladies meet for a house tour, where the current first lady shares some notes about residing in the historical home. According to Brower, there has been a sweet tradition in the handoff of the house. Case in point, Barbara Bush reportedly brought Hillary Clinton to a window in the First Lady's dressing room that overlooks the Rose Garden and the Oval Office. Hillary then showed it to Laura Bush on her tour, and Laura apparently did the same for Michelle Obama. Considering the fact that, as of the making of this video, Donald Trump has not yet conceded, there is no telling whether Melania Trump will continue the house tour tradition. If Melania does decide to show her home to its new resident, Joe Biden's wife, Jill Biden, they will be touring the premises before the end of January 2021. While Melania was in the public eye long before entering the White House, her life was even more heavily watched as First Lady and wife to the controversial 45th President of the United States. With that being said, it seems fair to assume her privacy might not be fully restored after she exits the White House in 2021. For their own protection, Donald and Melania will receive Secret Service protection for the rest of their lives, which comes with a significant loss of privacy. They could opt out of this protection, as Richard Nixon did in his later years, but considering the political climate coming out of the 2020 election, Trump will likely retain this protection indefinitely, as most presidents have. So what does it feel like to have this protection 24/7? Former Secret Service agent Jonathan Wackrow said in a 2016 interview with NBC News, "Secret Service protection is the most intrusive thing that anyone could ever experience. We experience parts of your life, but we're also there in those private times when things aren't good. Family arguments, family loss. We're there 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Nicki Swift videos about the latest hot topics are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one."